Space can be weird. Very weird. So weird, in fact, that astronomers are still being shocked by new and peculiar discoveries. One of the most peculiar planets in our solar system, Neptune, contains many mysteries yet to be uncovered. As the most distant planet from Earth, Neptune lies at the edge of the observable universe. The first time Neptune was seen by human eyes was through a state-of-the-art telescope back in 1846. The swirling surface and rich blue color earned the name Neptune after the Roman god of the sea. Previously, its existence had been discovered mathematically by astronomers after they noticed disturbances in the orbit of planet Uranus. Neptune has seldom been explored by astronomers. The first and only close-up of this mysterious planet was over 30 years ago, when Voyager 2 spacecraft flew by near enough to photograph it. No craft has ever been back since. Much of our knowledge about this colossal giant is in the dark, just like Neptune's own dark and brutally cold weather. What lies beneath Neptune's clouds? Will humanity ever be able to study it up close? And what will we find when we do? You're watching Matter, and today we're looking into what NASA found on Neptune's surface. First identified as a planet in the night sky in 1846, Neptune is one of the two ice giants in our solar system along with Uranus. It is the eighth planet in the solar system and sits at a distance of nearly 2.8 billion miles away. This is 30 times further from the Sun than the Earth sits, and where sunlight takes just about 8 minutes to get to us, it takes over 4 hours to reach the surface of Neptune. Neptune is also massive and measures nearly 4 times as wide as the Earth. Its atmosphere is primarily comprised of hydrogen, helium, and methane gas clouds that make up a large portion of Neptune's size. The thick gas clouds turn to a slurry of dense icy fluid made up of water, methane ice, and ammonia on top of a dense core made up of solid ice and rock. Its orbit is also gigantic. 1 year in Neptune time is equal to 165 years here. Neptune has only just completed its first full orbit around the Sun since its discovery in 2011. Voyager 2 has brought back a large amount of the data that astronomers have about Neptune, and much of their understanding of this planet comes from its flyby. Scientists were finally able to look closer at Neptune's composition, and there have been pushes to send another spacecraft back to collect more information. In 2011, as astronomers looked out to Neptune, they noticed a massive storm raging on the surface. This storm was big enough to cover half of the entire United States. This storm caused temperature to plummet to 128 degrees Celsius below zero, with winds blowing at a staggering speed. But this is not the only storm that has been seen on Neptune, and is not even close to the largest. Neptune is known for having dark spots on various points of its surface. In 1989, astronomers found what they dubbed the Great Dark Spot. This was a massive vortex storm on Neptune's surface that measures almost wider than the entire Earth at more than 11,000 kilometers wide. This storm had the fastest wind ever recorded on any planet in the solar system, raging at nearly 1,500 kilometers an hour. When most people hear about planetary rings, the first thoughts jump straight to Saturn. And while Saturn does have beautiful planetary rings, it is not the only planet to have this amazing feature. Neptune has a total of 5 rings that encircle the planet. Astronomers believe that these rings are relatively young and were most likely created long after the planet and solar system were formed. The 5 rings, starting with the closest to the planet's surface, are called Galley, Leverrier, Lassell, Arago, and Adams. These 5 rings vary greatly in their size and their orbit, with the closest ring located around 42,000 kilometers from Neptune's center, and the furthest ring is located nearly 63,000 kilometers from the center of the planet. Adams' ring comes at the thinnest of Neptune's rings, measuring only 50 kilometers at its widest and 15 kilometers at its narrowest. Lassell is the widest of Neptune's rings, with the majority of it measuring 4,000 kilometers wide. Its planetary rings are not the only thing orbiting around Neptune. Neptune is also home to 14 moons. The largest and most interesting of these moons is named Triton, after a lesser god of the sea in Greek mythology. One of the first things astronomers noticed about Triton was its orbit. It orbits Neptune in the direction opposite of the planet's rotation. This caught the eye of astronomers because it is the only planet in the entire solar system that exhibits this type of orbit. Triton is thought to have been floating through the solar system independently, until it got too close to Neptune and got caught up in the gravitational field. Astronomers want to study Triton closer up. They have already found incredible features on Triton's surface, including geysers spewing icy material up to 8 kilometers above the surface. Voyager 2 picked up information that confirmed that Neptune is hotter than its closer partner, Uranus. This piqued the interest of astronomers because Neptune is an ice giant, receiving very little heat from the Sun, and even though it is further from the Sun than Uranus, it is still hotter. Astronomers theorized that something must be heating the planet up near its core, and that the internal heat source is responsible for warming that entire planet. But what could this internal heat source be? The answer may come as quite a surprise. But first, Neptune has some other interesting features, such as its magnetic field that may play a role in this as well. Neptune has a strange magnetic field, in that it is much weaker than the one produced by the Earth. It comes in at only around a third of the strength of the Earth's magnetic field. In addition to being fairly weak, the magnetic field of Neptune is not in alignment with its rotational axis. In fact, the magnetic poles of Neptune are tilted about 47 degrees off its rotational axis. Astronomers aren't sure what the ramifications this has for the conditions on Neptune, and there still is debate as to what caused this tilting. It could have been a major impact that threw off the magnetic field, or it could be due to something else happening within the planet itself. In contrast to this weak magnetic field, Neptune's core remains extremely dense and hot. Neptune's core itself can reach temperatures over 7,000 degrees Celsius, quite a bit hotter compared to the Earth's core, which reaches temperatures just over 5,000 degrees Celsius. The pressure is also incredibly high near the solid core of Neptune due to the massive gaseous atmosphere and icy liquid layer beneath it. Due to the intense pressures and super hot temperatures, some scientists believe that these have led to something that sounds straight out of science fiction. Down in the depths of Neptune, there may be diamond rain. Astronomers know that there is an incredibly high pressure and heat beneath the upper atmosphere of Neptune. And due to this immense pressure, the hydrogen gas that exists in Neptune gets compressed to the point that it forms a metallic liquid version of hydrogen. As the hydrogen atoms are being compressed, the methane that makes up Neptune's atmosphere begins to break down and the bonds holding its hydrogen atoms to its carbon atom dissolve. This leaves behind a free carbon atom, and once it is free, stray carbon atoms begin to bind to one another. As the carbon atoms bond together to form larger molecules, the incredible pressure causes the chunks of bound carbon atoms to form into diamonds. Once these diamonds are formed, they fall to the planet, creating massive sheets of diamonds that could add to the gravitational energies of the core. If this theory is true, it could be the reason Neptune is warmer than the closer ice giant Uranus. The formation of diamonds in the methane clouds and subsequent fall of these diamonds would create a large amount of heat through friction and increased gravitational energies. Unfortunately, astronomers will not be able to know for sure what is happening on Neptune and why the planet is producing so much additional heat itself until they are able to send another well-equipped craft to get a closer look at this massive giant lurking in the far out in our solar system. Do you find Neptune as fascinating as we do? What other planets do you think have weird things going on? Be sure to watch us next time, and if you watched all the way to the end, we want to say thank you, and if you enjoy this video, please feel free to hit the like and subscribe button so you won't miss out on any of our future videos.